what do you do to stay relevant, to continue to stay relevant?
That's like the YouTuber's like nightmare, the like constant question they're asking themselves. Because we get to see it, you know? We see how views fluctuate. We see how numbers drop or go up. It's soul crushing. You know, like how well a video does. You're like, irrelevancy is knocking on my door. I need to step it up. It sucks. It's a horrible feeling. But I've been on YouTube for almost 9 years, and that feeling doesn't even compare to the feeling of having to chase like, I need to be relevant. And in 2012, Google changed their algorithm pretty harshly, and they left a lot of YouTube channels to the wayside. If you guys watched YouTube, you saw there's a lot of YouTube channels that were on the front page all the time. Like Daystorm is one of them. Now he's a popular Viner, so good for him. He switched platforms. But Google's harsh. They don't really care. They don't see the people behind the cameras that are putting in all their work and dedicating their career to trying make this become a YouTuber. You know, so I was one of those channels that got dropped to the wayside. No matter what I did, I went from being on the front page of YouTube every single week getting over 1 million views to barely getting 5,000 on my channel. And there was nothing I could do because it wasn't me. It was that Google wasn't seeding out my videos to my subscribers. I had become irrelevant not by my lack of work. Not by content or lack of work ethic. Mm-hmm. It was just the game. What changed with me was I don't want to be where YouTube is right now. I want to be where it is 2 years from now. And I don't believe it's necessarily YouTube is the only platform anymore. So what we do is we really work on trying to shape our content into being something that we're proud of. Mm-hmm. There's a game that you can play on YouTube where you collab with everyone and share their audience and your views are constantly driving up. And I think that's great and it works for a lot of people and that's a specific type of YouTuber. But I don't think that's me. I don't feel authentic when I do that. I do like collaborating with my friends, but it has to be on a certain kind of level. And when I'm doing a brand deal, I don't want it to just be, you know, a simple DSLR video. I want it to look nice. I want the brand to look at that video and be like, hey, this could be a commercial. Let's put this up on our website. That's how good it is. I want to sell quality, and I want people to see my brand and kind of be able to be like, oh, yeah, they're one and the same.